Testing 1, 2, 3. Oh, look at that. I just had to, you know, I don't know, get my mic working and actually turned on. I have an external mic and I have to connect it every time because I don't have my external mic constantly on. I bought it specifically for streaming and I completely forgot to connect it, so thank you for that. Because I would have gone the entire stream without talking to anyone, and I would have just been like, man, no one's talking to me. So let me do an introduction again. Hey guys, thank you for joining in our stream today. I was saying earlier, before Cowgirl said boo, I said, let's see who is lurking in our chat. And I was like, well, it looks like we got Cowgirl here. And then I was like giggling to myself. And so you missed the giggling to myself like a crazy person. That's great. And then I said that we are going to work on Aztecas today. In my team barn right here, I started focusing on Appaloosa and paint pattern. And I think that I'm going to change that and I'm going to only do paint pattern because I was starting to get a lot of Pintaloosa offsprings and that was not any help. So we've had a lot of new players recently, which means a lot of new people working on different things and concepts, which means a lot of new GP ups and downs and stuff. So I'm going to kind of go through all my horses. If we go to my ranch, I'm actually curious how many horses I have. I have 145, so I am actually getting pretty close to max on my horses here. Also, if I talk too fast, it's because I'm chugging my coffee here. Yes, more bugs. Except, I'm starting to get to the point, and this is what's really cool. I'm starting to get to the point where I'm not getting as many bugs anymore. And I'm getting just the repetitive of the same bug, but I'm starting to be able to like tackle those because I'm realizing, okay, well this bug is this bug is that, and like, you know, working through all of that. I think with these quarter horses here, and even with this Andalusian, we're gonna toss them. Because I'm pretty sure as far as ranking goes, we're gonna open up the horse rankings here. Because I'm pretty sure that, I know. Oh, wow. Okay, Lena. We see you, Lena. Look at Lena go. Wow. Okay. I want to see Azteca, and I want to see ABCD. Where is my quarter horse? Oh, it's up here. And see, I prefer these solids. So I don't want to use any of these studs, even though they're so much higher, because that's not going to help my breeding program at all. So Azteca wise, oh, I'm so sorry, guys. You guys are going to get bonked out of existence in a few seconds. I belong on that top screen. Sorry. I'm the Azteca queen here. Quarter horse wise, we finally got up to 400, which is amazing. Very, very glad we got up to 400 here. So if we're up to 400, then that means that my female quarter horses here at 381 are pretty useless. I'm going to just toss these guys into the wild because I don't need the money for it. What is this horse? At 501. And what did I just say that the Andalusians were? 588 for Appy and 576 for non-Appy. So yeah, you're pretty useless too. I'm gonna toss you. And so that leaves me with my two purebred leopard stallions here. Is he back up for stud? He is not. I'm gonna put him up for stud again. And then we've got a bunch of my fails here. We're gonna open all of them. Now, where am I at with team? My team is at 420 GP. So these guys are definitely higher than my team. And we're at purebred. Huh. I don't know why I started breeding them separate then. Are you a solid? You are a solid. Okay, well, I'm gonna hold on to you. You are not. You're not purebred. I'm gonna toss you. You're not purebred. I'm gonna toss you. You're not purebred. I'm gonna toss you. Not purebred. Toss. I have not been on in a while to actually look at this. So here we got another stallion. Oh, filly. We're gonna do leopard 100%. I forgot that I removed that out. We're gonna toss you. I'm gonna toss you. I'm gonna get to the point though in a second that I'm gonna say if anybody wants some, you guys can have some. So, kind of narrowed this down a little bit. I'm gonna close these windows. So this is still my team here. And then this is my extras barn. So these guys are all available for sale. If you guys are interested on any of these Aztecas, I will do 2,500 for any of these guys. Yeah. Gremlin. Tab back over. I tabbed away for a second. So I'm gonna sort this by GP and we can see what we can trash first. And then these guys all have GP names. Are these guys in a barn or a pasture? They're in a barn. And here I thought that I had horses in my team pasture. But it looks empty. So I think what I'm going to do is move the ones I'm going to keep over. So we're gonna move some of my highest. I'm gonna have to redo my entire my entire line to figure out what I want to do as far as everything. You know, when you get a lot of quarter horses in the game that are starting to go up, it's not far-fetched for people to just become the top of the ranking for something, because when you make crosses, it just randomly happens. So it's not surprising that it can happen. I haven't done a Azteca stream for this in probably 3 months. So... but if you're interested in Aztecas, I do have this team. So if you're interested on joining it, it's typically used for me and my streaming. But I'm fine with people, like, you know, breeding off the site, like, you know, and continuing it without me managing it much. So if you were interested in that, feel free to let me know. Okay, so we've moved some of these horses to this pasture. And then these are my rejects, or these are my old ones. And I'm going to move these guys into my Azteca's barn, since they are Aztecas. But they are not going into the team barn. Okay, so this should just be... Okay, perfect. That is what I want. So we're gonna close this barn now, because I don't need it. And then we've got the team barn. And then we've got this. So these are my top GPs. And we're gonna refresh this again, since I just moved some into here. Okay, and let me see what I can do with these guys, since I don't want to be using them anymore, and I don't know if I can move them out. When you're a part of a team, depending on who the owner is if you can move them back to your personal ranch. So Sequoia actually bred these guys. So I actually haven't worked on it. This one was in January. So, yeah, it looks like these are all around January that I actually was active. Wow, it's been that long. I get caught up with doing everything else, but I'm trying to get more involved with the community again and working on all of that. So I'm going to move all of the ones that I can back into my personal barn so that we can sell them and I can get them out and they won't be part of the breeding group. These guys must all be under GP release. Okay. So this should be empty. Got two more. And those are the ones I want. These are the ones I'm sorting. Literally had three barns worth of Aztecas. If you are here on our YouTube, feel free to say hello. I've never really streamed on YouTube before, so I don't really know how to even see if I have viewers. But I love chatters. I love people talking with us and communicating. So feel free to say hello, because I say hello back. Okay, so these are our top GPs, and this is empty now, right? Yes. Okay, and so this is this. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You need a total of 8 to start a breeding line by the breeding chart that I have released. If you haven't seen our breeding chart, if you're in our Discord server and you look in our pins, let me switch over here. If you look in our pins on the general chat, scroll down. Yep, I've got the Ropin Ranch DP breeding guide pinned in the general chat. So that is a chart that I follow for all of my stuff. If you want to start completely fresh with new horses, I would suggest that you just toss everybody into the wild. Because what happens is if you restart your game, you are going to have all of your money wiped and all of your horses are going to get tossed into the wild. So literally the same exact outcome for the horses is that everybody goes to the wild. The only difference is that you lose all your seniority, you lose all your inventory, you lose all of your coins, you lose everything. It resets you as if you just registered right then and there. So I would honestly suggest just tossing everybody to the wild and start over that way if you want to keep funds and all of that other stuff. Because otherwise you are starting 100% completely brand new baby out of the womb. Okay. So I said we need how many more? We've got 5. I want 6, 7, 8. We'll pull these guys in real quick. And what do we got? We got female, female, female. So I need one of these to be a female. That is a female. Awesome. So this is our 4th female. Which theoretically would mean that these two are males. Yep, male and a male. Cool. So we'll start with this for a second. Okay. So I don't need this barn anymore, and let's open this one and see what this is going on. Okay. So we got our 8. So now, once you have your 8, I grab a piece of paper. Now you pick your pairs. So I'm going to open everybody in another window again. And you look at everybody's family tree to see who's related. Okay. Now, female. This was a female. And then this was a female. So I've got my males up here and my females on this side. So I want to label this one first by its name so I can remember. So 425, and we're going to name her Mermaid. Because cowgirl is here and I have to use my brain. And then we're gonna do this guy is going to be, what was he, 425? 425 Benjamin, or no, Benji. I'm gonna do Benji. He's Benji. Okay, so we got Benji, and then his name can be Colt. We'll just keep him. So my highest out of all of these is Colt. So I want to take Colt and breed him to my highest female. So Mermaid. Now let's make sure that they aren't related. Legacy and Wild Horse and Buck and River. They are not related. So they can breed together without having a cross. So then I'm going to pick my next highest. So we're going to do Benji. And we're going to go to Raven, which Stormy and Frida, Dalton and Haven, they are not related. So Raven. We're going to close those two. Then I'm going to do Hugo, because he's my next highest. To Sarah. And they are not related, so that'll work. and that leaves Dutch and Skye together. So now we have our chart on who breeds who. My next thing is the fact that I have some foals in here. So I'm going to get these guys prepared. These guys are all trained already and ready. So I'm going to get these guys prepped for going to the trainer. I didn't know that this was a free song, but I like this song. Now, it is going to be cheaper if you go to the trainer and your horse is halter trained. Just a little tip, if nobody knows this, if you are halter training in your horses and gait training them, it is going to be significantly cheaper to send them to the trainer. So that is what I'm doing here, is reducing legitimately my price to send them off. Okay, so that one's an adult, and I'm gonna open up my trainer here. And colt. What is my instant? 4,700 and 19 moons versus 19 moons and 9,500. I can afford that. Let's do instant. And then we're gonna get mermaid up. Also, if you don't know, if you haven't been playing the game, increasing or training your horses will increase your GP. If your both parents are trained, it increases your GP by 2 points above the average. So it is very, very helpful. Would always recommend it, especially if you're doing GP breeding. Now, honestly, I probably don't have to train these guys because these guys are not going to be my top. I just want to kind of average out a little bit before I move forward. And honestly, I could potentially go higher and go breed the top horse in the game, but I don't want to do that right now. So I'm just going to do this for a second and then get us some offsprings to work with. See, she's more expensive because she was older. I might not do Benji since Benji is not close. Yep. Doing any of this will technically cut down your time and the price that it is. I don't think I'm going to send Benji. Not because I don't have the money, but because I just technically don't have to for what my goal is for this, real quick. Okay. Because I'm nowhere close with the top GP right now. I'll have to look again at what it was. It is the coolest thing. Every time I say this, I feel self-centered. But it is the coolest thing to actually be able to play a game that you created. Like, it's super, super cool. Okay, so I'm going to open up the rankings again over here. We're going to close Benji, close this, refresh this, And let's look at the Aztecas for a second again. See, I see three people are watching via YouTube, but how do I know who they are? So 478 is our highest. Now, let's do some math. Just like mentally math this all together here. If my top ones are colt and mermaid, and colt is 447, and mermaid is 425, my outcome is going to be 447 plus 425 divided by 2 is going to be a 436. That 436 is nowhere near this top. And so we're just going to be kind of cutting our horses lower because now I'm going to have a 436 when my highest is the 447. So theoretically, you're going to want to get to the top before you... Where is... Oh, okay. Sorry. My mouse is dying and it's blinking. So I'm trying to find the cord, but I just found the cord. There we go. It plugged in. It's a little crumpled. Gotta move the monitor. Okay, cool. So what I think I'm gonna do... Well, I haven't done any breeding yet. We're gonna go to the market for a second. And we're gonna do Andalusian, and then I'm gonna do a quarter horse. So I want the top GP Andalusian without any of this. Okay, my mouse is like plugging in and then unplugging and then plugging in and unplugging. Can you like stop that? Thank you. This one here is a 560 at 50,000. I don't really need to go that high, except, okay, well, we're just gonna view. We're just gonna theoretically look through all this. And then GP this one. Our top is going to be this 369. Stop. Stupid mouse. Give me my mouse back. Okay. And this one's actually not purebred. I didn't even notice this. So we want to go backwards. Oh my gosh. So this one is my top. It also has some horseshoes items on it. Is this being sold by Ropin Ranch? I think I actually sold this on the Ropin Ranch account because it is. Yep. I saw this one and I was like, I'm gonna sell this. So, something Velcro is stuck to my socks under my desk. Okay. So if we bought these two horses, we're at a 456 plus a 369. So we're technically even lower by buying those. The next thing I'm going to check is what is the highest in both of the stud markets. Because we want to figure out what's going to be the cheapest, fastest way to get what we're looking for. So the highest GP Andalusian was the one that was 456. So this one here at 572, which is extremely higher, is only 5,000. And if I do a quarter horse, this 400 here, it might be 22,000, but it is definitely still higher. and like I could technically even go for these guys and still be pretty high. So those pairings, if I did something like that, would get me a 486. So that is definitely much higher than what I was. So what I might do is, this 369 here, I'm gonna buy this stallion here. And then I'm gonna rename it. And then we're gonna flip its gender real quick so that we can breed it to that 572. Oh, this is a fun song. And we're just gonna search the page for Pick Me so that I can find it. My YouTube friends, who are you? You guys make me so curious. Who is here? Okay. Oh, this is gonna have an amazing bass drop. Okay, I like this song. Okay, so this horse here is now a female, which is great. We are gonna move her into my Andean quarter horse barn. And once she is there, we are going to age her up a little bit. She's not trained at all, but just wait for the method to my madness. So we're going to public covering her to that stud that I found that was an Andalusian stud for 5,000. We've now spent 10,000 because she was a $5,000 horse when we purchased them. Let's switch you over to mare and foal. And age you. And this baby is a male. And what is it going to be? It's going to be high. A 471. So I'm right under you now. I have to get it higher than a baby though. So we're gonna start taming a little bit while I'm doing this. I'm gonna age up by one and we look here. Should be right under. Yep. Okay, I'm coming for ya. So now that we've got that one, let's age up. And we're gonna add this one to our breeding program. Okay, let's move you. Here. And who is the lowest male? We've got Hugo, we've got Benji, we got Dutch. Dutch, it's time to go. You're being evicted from the household. So Dutch is leaving us. And I'm going to name this one 471. Coming for you. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to bring you home. Okay, so now we're starting to get some of our grouping higher, which is really good. Now what I want to do is I want to flip it. I'm not buying this one. I don't think so. Okay, so 456 plus 400, because that was the highest, is 428, and then you know what? It's probably best. I'm gonna breed a female out of the pair that I just got. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna breed a female out. So we're gonna close this. We're gonna get a... Where is the horse that I was just playing with in the barn? Stupid Velcro on my foot again! It is like playing footsies with me under the table. Okay, so Miss Pick Me over here. We are picking you. I'll deal with that in a second. We're going to public covering you again. And we're going to purebred. And technically, if I breed to him, they're not related. They're related by mother, but not anything else. Yes, I know, you're feeling lethargic. Me too, all the time. All the flippin' time. See, I don't know if you know about that, but if you move quickly, you can theoretically deworm and vaccinate your horses very quickly. I also, once this is over, which I think I'm only going to do about another 15 minutes of this, once I'm done with this, I'm going to go work on a new event, which I will spoiler for everybody here, is a lottery. It's going to be a very, very easy way to get money. We're going to see how it works, because honestly, I think I really like that coat. He is cute. He is really cute. It's going to be really, really cool. I think that people are going to get a lot of money out of it. And yeah. Let's start taming him. I just saw a shadow on my back, like from behind me. And now I'm wondering if my boyfriend is outside. I don't see him. Did someone just pass my door? That's gonna be really fun during the school year. We only have about 2 more weeks and people are going to start moving in on campus, and all of my peace and quiet is going to be gone. So we're gonna see how that is for streaming. I also have a really, really loud fan in my apartment, which I don't know if this mic is picking it up. I'm gonna have to listen to the stream and figure that out. So that's gonna be fun. Okay, so who are we evicting from the household next? We're gonna evict Benji. Benji, it's time to go. Yeah, honestly, Toast is like just walking. Dude, okay, so cowgirl, the other day I was sitting here at the desk. I had a bowl full of apples and I'm like eating apples because I was like, I need a healthy snack. Obviously, I'm going to eat apples because, yeah, healthy. Sitting here and Toast jumps on the back of the couch and I'm like, aw, he's so cute. Hi, Toast. What are you doing here? And so I'm like giving him little pets on his little head because he's, you know, the cutest little bunny ever. And he sneaks forward and he snatches the apple and then takes off running across the room. The little stupid boy, smart boy, took the apple and ran. And I was like, are you kidding me right now? Yeah. Little sneaky boy he is. Sneaky, sneaky. Very sneaky boy. I love my Toast, though. Okay, so this time I'm going to breed to this guy. It should be another horse that does not have any correlation or relation. Okay, there goes that. You know what? It must be a tree. It must be a tree. I just saw the shadow on my back again, or on my wall, and I was like, what is that? Okay, okay. Yes. I'll look at that. Bye, cowgirl! Do, 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 do. I like this song, too. This song's a jammer. Oh! It's Coda! I just now saw. Oh, it's Nevi! I was like, I don't know who Coda is, but hey. Are you already, subscribed to our channel on YouTube, Nevi? You know what? That's not a bad idea either. Do, 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 do. Okay. I'm gonna do that after. Sometimes I'm smart, and sometimes I'm not smart. Okay. Gonna get this. Wait, was this a girl or a boy? I didn't even look. This is a girl! Awesome. So we're gonna name her. Nervy. It's gonna be Nevy. Look at that. Also, hold on to that thought. Don't leave within the next like 40 minutes. Like, not like leave me, but like just like don't go to school. This just in, Ropin Ranch tells its students not to go to school. I mean, like, don't, like, stay in the Discord for a few minutes after I end this stream, because I'm gonna do something. We're gonna get rid of Sky next. Okay. I've got to relook at all my stuff here in a second and see if I'm going to inbreed anybody, because I don't want to. So we're going to close this and refresh this. I have so much paper on my desk, it's not even funny. So colt was going to breed to mermaid, which we still can do, because they still have stayed. Benji is gone, but Raven is still here. So I'm going to do hunting fun to Raven. And then Hugo and Sarah were together. Where's Hugo? Okay, I'll take Hugo and I'm gonna do Hugo and Nevi now. And then Dutch and Sky were together. Well, that's gonna be coming for you. I have too many in here. I have one too many. We're gonna get rid of Sky. So coming for you and Sarah is gonna be our next grouping. Hello, Misty! Drop a follow. I know who you are, and you will get 50,000 coins in the game for following us here on Twitch. I see it's your first time chatting, so definitely, definitely do that. Okay. Do I still have too many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I do. So who am I not talking about? Colt and Mermaid. Hunting Fun and Raven. Hugo and Nevi. Wait, I just thought I moved Sky. Sky, did you somehow, like, sneaky beaky? Did I not move her? I thought I moved her. Awesome. I didn't see it come in. Huh. Interesting. Maybe it takes a second. Sky, get out of here. Yeah, because normally it pops up the little notification thingy on my screen and says, you know, someone followed. But it didn't do that. We're going to move you out of here. Get out. Out. Bye. Yeet. Skirt. Okay. So... what do we... This is one. Colt and Mermaid. I think I'm going to breed them one more time. No, not pasture. Stable. I'm going to breed them one more time. And that way I can potentially get Mermaid. Colt is high, but I'd like him to get higher. So either Mermaid or Colt I'd like to replace. So that way we've got a little bit of everything coming down. And we can start at a little higher. And then I think we're ready to start our first generation, which is not bad. Okay, public covering. That is really weird. wonder why. I wonder why it didn't do that. Also, if any of you guys have Amazon Prime, if you actually connect your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account, you can do a free subscription to any channel you want every month. So if any of you guys have that, I would very, very much appreciate those. It definitely helps get some of the funds into the Ropin Ranch account so that I can commission some stuff out. And I just would very much appreciate if any of you guys have Twitch. I'm already subbing for myself, so I can't really do it. Which, actually, I might ask my friend Caitlin, who has Amazon Prime. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and I should text my sister too. I'm thinking this all through now. Okay, so we got female or male? We got a female. So this is a 471. So we're gonna do, I'm gonna name her Misty after Misty Meadows. Okay. So Misty, you are going into the barn for our breeding program here, and we're gonna toss Sarah out. Yeah, I try to do it based on people that are watching because, like, I can never remember names, and, like, it just, it's kind of fun. Do, doodle, doodle, do, get out, Sarah, do. Okay. This is going to give us an upper hand on getting some of these out and ready. So we're going to coey here now. And I'm going to, let's calculate what our next generation is going to be. On Colt and Misty, which are going to be our pairings, 447 plus, wait, who did I toss? Sarah? No, I wanted Sarah. Wait, what was Sarah? Gosh, my brain hurts. Okay, Sarah's going to stay, we're going to do mermaid here. Yes. Okay, we're just switching around a little bit. So 447 to 471 divided by 2. We're going to get a 459 for that connection. Then hunting fun, which is a 470 plus raven, 422 divided by 2. We're going to get a 446. And then we're going to do Hugo. If that's it coming through. It's not, but yellow golden ducky. Thank you for the follow. I don't know what you followed on. You followed on Twitch. Thank you. If you actually drop your Ropin Ranch username in our chat, we will give you 50,000 coins for the for doing so. Thank you. So now my brain hurts. Hugo and Nevi, you are having a child, okay? We're doing some parenting planning going on here. So Hugo's a 422, Nevi is a 470. We're dividing that by 2 and we're getting another 446. And then we're doing Coming For You, which is a 471, plus Mermaid, who is a 425, dividing that by 2 to get a 448. Okay, so if that's our next generation, we can work with that. I think I'm only going to need to breed I think I need to only breed one per generation, to be honest. I'm not sure if I remember. So let's see, who do we have that's an adult? Colt and Misty, no. Hunting, Fun, and Raven, no. None of them are adults. So let's get them all up to adults real quick. I hate this gray in my thing. Awesome, what was your username in the game? Yeah, if you guys are following and you guys have subbed or followed in the past, I've asked before most of the time, but then I forget to, like, you know, get people's stuff. But awesome, I will write you down. You are written down on my paper, which, as soon as this stream is over, I was actually planning on doing another 50,000 coin giveaway for everybody that subs or follows us on YouTube, but I'm going to do that a little differently, so don't start going over there yet, because I have to figure out a way that's going to be a method to our madness. So don't start attacking yet. 2 months, we need to go 2 more. Okay. Nevi, we're going to get a Coggins test on you because you might be awful. So we're going to do my stallions. And Nevi was supposed to go to who? Hugo. I love that so much because Hugo is the name of Tony and I's stuffed animal bear, and he's a giant bear, and he sits in Tony's office, and they have decked him out in the office with sunglasses and a hat, and he has like a gold chain around his neck, and like all of the students decorate Hugo in the office because it's super funny. And so I love that you are breeding with Hugo. Oh my gosh, you had the cutest baby. Wait a second, is this a Chocolino? Okay, it's not, thank goodness. I was going to be like, never mind, kill it with fire. So 447 here, and we're gonna name her Almond. And she's gonna be the start of our next generation for A. Dang it, okay. Can I do this? Okay, I've allowed dashes. I need to add in... Hold on, I'm doing a little bit of coding for a second. Okay, right now, speak now, hold your peace. What characters do you guys want to be able to do in the names that I have currently not allowed? That's, I cannot do apostrophes. Apostrophes will kill the code. That's the one I cannot do. Unfortunately. We were allowing apostrophes before. That's why I had to add this in. And because they were people adding apostrophes, it was breaking the entire screen. And every time they were taking them to the vet, it was also like not allowing them to do certain things and activities because they had an apostrophe and the code thought that it was part of the code. this should let me do what I at least want to do right now, which shouldn't break the code. Let's see, does this work? 447 almond. Maybe I have to refresh. Let me try it again. 447 almond. Oh, I did it for the barn name. Let me try this. Oh, I'm doing the wrong thing. Hold on. This needs to be in a different script. Okay, we're gonna try this again. Be a developer, they said, when you can do anything you want just for what you want. Ha! Hey, Hazel! Okay, there we go. I got my parentheses. That's something I can try. No, it sucks because, like, you guys come up with the craziest names that cause, like, problems, and ugh, I try really hard not to be, you know, a stickler for it, but when everything's dying and breaking, Team Pasture. Okay. I love that name. That's a good one. Okay, so 447 almond is going to be our start here. Let me do... What time are we at? We're at 1 hour and 12 minutes. I'm going to breed down one offspring for each of these babies. And then, then we'll end the stream here, and then I can go ahead and do what I want to do for the YouTube before I have to go get lunch and leave for work today, which is going to be a whole fun. I don't know if you guys heard about the chaos that is currently going on with CloudStrike, which is a large company for security on a lot of Microsoft operating systems and stuff like that. But pretty much they decided to push an update without checking if it was going to break stuff. And now thousands of people are stuck because the computers are completely blue screened and there's like thousands of flights that have been canceled and delayed. So yeah, that's a lot of fun. And it apparently has affected my work. So when I go into work, they said to be aware that some of the computers are not working and that we are going to be having a very fun day today. So it's gonna be very fun for me. Keep aging until you can breed. Did I go through all the way there? I did. Okay. All the way through. Okay, you're ready. And then we're gonna go ahead and get Misty ready. Running low on moons. Come on. I just need everybody to give me one baby, and then tomorrow I'll do another stream with more information and stuff like that. Okay, so Misty is going to colt. I did public somehow. Colt has not had a Coggins test, so he's not going to display until now. Awesome. So I'm really hoping we can get rid of some of this freaking gray. I am not a fan of the gray curse. Gray is my least favorite gene in the game. Some of you guys love the gray horses. I hate them with a passion. Mulberry gray, that's not awful. And hopefully that'll only have one of the genes. So we're gonna do 460 and we're gonna name her Angel. No, I'm not gonna do that because she's a different letter. So she's gonna be Bonnie. Bonnie for B. Okay. And then, who's our next one? Raven is going to go to Hunting Fun, and Mermaid are our other two. It is a Andalusian and a quarter horse together. She must still be recovering. And while I'm here, I'll just do it. Wildwood Rose. Okay, you two should have just gotten your coins. So Mermaid. I move really fast with my tabs too, by the way. I am not trying to make anyone dizzy. Okay, so Mermaid is gonna go to my stallions. And she is going to Coming For You. And Raven is going to Hunting Fun. Okay, so now both are pregnant. Let's birth a baby and be done before the boyfriend comes back and says we need to go to lunch. Oh my goodness, you are a gorgeous little baby. I love you so much. I love her. I love her. I love her. I love her. Okay. She's going to be a C, but we need to figure out. She's a 449. I'm going to name her Cleo. She is so cute. I love her. Okay, Raven, you're gonna have to either beat that and give me a cuter baby, or you're gonna have to suffer. Okay, okay. He's cute, he's cute. He's a blue roan, and I'm gonna do 447 dusk D. Okay. So, we have started getting our little grouping of horses together. And I'm going to quickly write down what our next pairing is going to be since we have gone up. Raven and Mermaid are now knocked out of the rolls because they are the lowest GPs. So is Hugo. So I would like to... I have three females. And what I want to do real quick is name these guys the pair names that I did. So Mermaid... Who is Mermaid the parent of? And Raven. And Nevi. And... is Cleo. Okay, so Mermaid. And coming for you is a C. Is this going to be too long? Yes, okay. So I'm just going to have to remember that coming for you is a C. And then Dusk, which is D, is Raven. So we're going to do 422. Oh my gosh. Raven. And the reason we do this is so that we... do not inbreed. That's too long as well. We're just gonna do D then, like this. And then this came from who? Nevi? Nevi, you're an A. 470. And Nevi was paired to Hugo, so that means Hugo is also an A. And that leaves Misty as a B. I'll show you what this does. So now we know that who was the lowest? Raven. And Raven was a D. So I cannot replace Raven with Dusk, but that's correct because Raven, wait, how did Bonnie get to be a 460? Wow. Okay. So we're going to change and do... we're going to get Raven out of here. So hunting fun is going to breed... to... I'm going to replace it with Bonnie. because they will not be inbred there. But that will get rid of Raven, which is our lowest. It's a lot of math in your brain. And then Mermaid is 425. She's a C, but I can't replace her with this. So let's do this. We're gonna put Cleo with Hunting Fun. And then we're gonna put Bonnie. With Coming For You. Because they won't be inbred either. Because those are C's. And then Dusk is the same. It's very close to these two. And Almond here came from Nevi and where's the A? Hugo. Interesting. I'll have to figure out the rest of it. But theoretically, we will discuss more next time I do a stream. So I want to thank everybody for coming, like always. I got the two people for their usernames. You have been given out your rewards. And then look forward to an update in our Discord server that I will be posting here in a few minutes that will be giving away coins for our YouTube. So I hope everybody has a lovely day. Thank you for joining in and talking and being my friend. Peace.